we had a plastic framed Last Supper in our kitchen, and we had what everyone thought was the New York skyline hanging over the sofa, until I got to New York and discovered it didn't even resemble the New York skyline. But never, it didn't really live with it. And then it took me a long time to realize that my mom had a good eye and was creative. We didn't have any money, so that she did crafts kind of things. She went to the wallpaper store at the end of every season, and they gave her the samples, and she would cover cigar boxes and then sell them at the church bazaar. And and that was the extent of the artistic environment in our home. So it wasn't until I started traveling. One night I was in Paris, and I went to a small gallery in Montmartre and saw a Frank Stella painting. And I had no idea who he was. The painting was, I still think about it, it was just absolutely beautiful. It was small, it was round, and it was $10,000. And at the time I was making $1,000 a month plus a used cutlass. And I didn't even net $10,000. So the thought of spending that kind of money on a piece of art was just, it was inconceivable. So I came back to New York and went to the New York Public Library. I didn't know where else to go, and looked up Mr. Stella, and have since become, pretty enthralled with him and his work. And I just got very, very interested in him and started to study him. I didn't realize it was a maquette. It was a study for the real thing. We now own the real painting, and it's hanging in our library, and it's been in our home for, God, what?
A long time.
Probably at least 30 years.
Well, actually, and he'll have to tell you the story about how he started going down to the Pace Gallery on East Broad Street, the Auxiliary Pace Gallery.
English.
Yeah, even that her son, who has the big main Pace Gallery in New York, let his mother have one, and her goal was to try to get people in Columbus interested in contemporary art. And she had really, really good artists and so forth. And so he got to be a friend. She was his first mentor to really expose him to a lot of things and to allow him to purchase things.
She did allow us to purchase, mm-hmm. and we still own the first piece we've ever purchased. We'll never part with it. It'll either come to the museum or it'll go to one of our kids. We haven't figured that out yet, but we'll never let it go up elsewhere. The process we went through with Frank Stella, we're going through many, many, few decades later, and we're doing the same thing. Also, it's very important for us to meet the artists, and we've had the privilege of meeting, Dubuffet and de Kooning and some of the masters of the 60s and 70s. And even today, I love going to studios, love to watch artists make work. We watched Chuck Close make a painting that we ended up buying, and it's now at the Whitney. And it was a portrait of Francesco Clemente. And every time I went to New York, pretty frequently then, and every trip I went to the studio and watched him progress through this huge, huge, huge portrait. And it was fun.
I've always said too, when it comes to collecting and other people getting involved and so forth, that if you go and look at a lot of art, and let's say you don't really know anything about art, and you go and you go to places that you should reasonably be able to assume they have good art. Now, every piece won't be equally good, and even in a museum, but go places where you think you should be able to see good art and start looking. And the more you look, the more your eye will be drawn to certain types of things. And then Ron always says, you don't buy a piece of art. Number one, you've got to feel comfortable with what you're paying for it. And number two, you have to be willing to get up every morning and look at it.
And love it.
And so that's kind of, what we've always said to people, when they think they want to start collecting.
We're also pretty proud of the acceptance and the of the collection, and the response we've gotten from the community. And this is something, you know, we build warehouses for a living, so the vast majority of the collection is warehoused in racks and in shelves and what have you, and it's in an unmarked building, and we've never revealed a location, Ann and I came to the conclusion a few years ago that we have to do something else. We have to start sharing what we have. Anyway, we're excited to be part of the museum, and just so excited that we're, you know, I hope the community gets this.
I think the community is going to just love this.